the bodybuilder from Thailand. My opinion on the whole situation, that he used dirty gear. My supposedly, though, I heard the guy from Thailand, Dan, what's his name? Tony Hughes' friend. My opinion on it is, I think he got debunked gear, bad gear, and he didn't use clean syringes, my opinion. And the opinion on it is, he didn't clean with rubbing alcohol. When he shot it, he got infected, supposedly. Is it a scam? I don't think so. Jerry Ward saying it's a scam. Everybody saying it's a scam. You can't fake debunked gear, my friends. Debunked gear is fake. It's bullshit. It's fake. You're putting basically juice in your body. It's fake. All fake and dirty gear. Some of it just synthetic crop they put in there from wherever, Thailand or China. And my opinion is when he injected it, he didn't take care of the infection, and supposedly it got infected from debunked gear. He didn't use clean needles, probably. He didn't use clean rubbing alcohol. He didn't do all the procedures he needed to do to stop the infection. He didn't take care of the infection with medication, unfortunately, from the doctors. So it spread and it got really bad. God bless his soul, Dan, from Thailand. He got donations, and he's going to get surgery. He'll be fine. Supposedly he won't lose his leg. God bless his soul. Is it a scam? I don't think so. There is such a thing as debunked gear, fake gear, and fake gear can happen if you get the wrong dealer, unfortunately. He probably had the wrong dealer, wrong supplier, and unfortunately got infected from it. And, he got infected. And it happens. I've heard this shit all the time in fitness, people getting fake debunked gear and all that stuff, and people getting infected and losing their limbs or losing their arms from crap. I mean, it's probably 80% fake garbage. The stuff, my source is all legit. I never get infected, unfortunately, but poor guy, I feel sorry for him. This just very rarely happens. I've heard of it. Never heard of this crazy infection. This crazy, unfortunately. This is a very bad situation. God bless his family and his soul. Dan from Thailand, Tony Hughes' friend. I'm doing a video on it now. In my opinion on it, yes, you can get fake gear, debunked gear, and you can get infections if you don't clean it and take care of the wound very fast. Unfortunately, it goes with the territory. A lot of people who use fake gear, unfortunately, do get infections, sometimes do lose their limbs. It can be a bad situation. There is such a thing as debunked gear. Like, I've had fake gear, and I almost lost my limb. I got a big lump. Remember the spider bite, supposedly? That got really bad. I got an infection. I got some fake baloney, and it was some trim, and luckily I didn't lose my limb, but I took care of it. I got medication to take it down. I hope and bless his soul he doesn't lose his limb, I have other things to talk about on my topic today, but I just want to mention this. I hope he does well, and